Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs. And in this class I will be dealing with the very important topic related to environment, that is the topic of fracking technology. Fracking technology. Now, first of all, we need to understand what is meant by fracking technology. This is the technology that is used to extract shale gas and shale oil from the rocks. The rocks that are at a depth of more than or in the range of around 2000 meters to 2500 meters. Now, the shale gas and the shale oil is trapped in the rocks at such a depth, the depth of 2000 meters and 2500 meters. Now, this is a huge depth when it comes to the man's ability to explore Earth's depth. We have not been able to explore a lot of Earth's depth physically by drilling the Earth or by going deep in the earth. So how this extraction process is actually done, how we are able to derive the oil or the shale gas from such a depth. Now the oil that is trapped in the rocks is extracted by using this technology that is called as fracking technology. Now this technology has helped the economies to strengthen themselves politically and economically by extracting the shale gas. But this technology, it has lot of environment related repercussions. It impacts the environment in a bigger way, in a big way. Now how it impacts, that's the most important thing to be discussed. Because if you're deriving some sort of energy from the rocks and you are using that energy for some purpose, you also need to actually give an input to derive that energy. Now what is the input that is required in the fracking technology? The first input that is required is the water, and the huge amount, this amount of water is huge. And secondly, the input that is required in the fracking technology is the chemicals. Now how this fracking technology works? Now let us suppose this is the lithosphere, the rocksphere, and this is the depth, maybe till 5000 meters, we'll be able to find the shale gas and the oil at the depth of 2000. Let us suppose this is 2500 meters and this is 2000 meters. We need to do the vertical drilling first of all, and then we need to do the horizontal drilling. So this is how the drilling is actually done. And when the drilling is done, the water under huge pressure, now this is important, the water under huge pressure along with the chemicals is pumped into this drill, and this actually helps in extracting the oil out of it and the gas out of it, and that gas is used to run the economies worldwide. Now this shale gas is getting popular, this shale oil is getting popular, this natural gas is getting popular, but the repercussion it has, that it uses in terms of input, it uses huge amount of water. Now this same water that we are using to extract this energy, this could be used somewhere else. Because first of all, we need to actually weigh the amount of benefits that we will be deriving by using this water in extracting the shale gas or using this water for some other purposes. Now when it comes to the usage of water, there are certain primary purposes for which the water is used, and there are certain secondary purposes for which the water is used. Now, the primary purpose for the water is actually drinking water. This is the most, because man cannot survive without water. Most of our body is made up of water. So this is the basic primary requirement of our body. Now, the second requirement, the primary purpose of the water is irrigation. So drinking water and irrigation are the primary purposes. So the water, first of all, should be used for these purposes. And once we have fulfilled these purposes, we can use water for some other purpose. That is, we can use it for deriving whatever energy we want from the shale gas and shale oil. But it won't be a fair idea. It won't be a fair idea to keep on using this water, because we have billions who don't have access to clean drinking water. And we have millions of hectares of land that is actually looking out for water. So we have a lot of land to quench its thirst in order to derive crops out of it, in order to push, in order to assess the food security for our country. So until and unless our basic requirements for water are fulfilled, we should not be using this water for the purposes like extracting, because that will be impacting environment. Our entire land will get parched. That will have an impact on the erosion. The land will be getting eroded at a faster pace. That will also impact biodiversity. That will also impact the salt composition of the soil. There will be a lot of evaporation, and that evaporation will push the salt on the top layer of the soil. So the entire composition, the salt composition of the soil, will also undergo a change. Erosion will undergo a change. Water tables will undergo a change. The aquifers will be getting parched. The biodiversity will be impacted. And these impacts will be getting multiplied due to the climatic change that is actually impacting the human race. So this is the first bigger impact of the fracking technology on the environment, because of the excessive input use of water in extracting shale gas and shale oil. And the second biggest impact is that we will be using a lot of chemicals in deriving this, in extracting the shale gas and oil. Because water alone will not help us to extract this shale gas and shale oil. When we will be pumping a lot of chemicals and the groundwater level, that will actually be impacting the health of the citizens who will be drinking such water, because most of the chemicals that is used in the fracking technology, they have a nature that is carcinogenic. Now, what is carcinogenic? Carcinogenic means that it will cause cancer to the people. So this fracking technology, though it helps the countries to give them a lot of political push and economical push, but that has a lot of impact on the environment because of the excessive use of the chemicals and the water. So the cost of the shale gas, it will not only be the economic cost that we will be bearing, it will also be the environment cost, and that cost, and that will impact the sustainable development process. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.